Keeping up with the trend of 18:9 displays, HTC has launched an upgraded variant of the U11 called the U11 Plus. It's just been launched in India and it goes up against the likes of the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus, LG V30 Plus and Google Pixel 2 XL. This packs in flagship level hardware under its shiny mirror finished exterior and has a potent camera as well. But is that enough to help it stand out? Well, here's our review. Now before we go ahead, be sure to subscribe to the Gadgets 360 YouTube channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you're the first to know about our new videos. The HTC U11 Plus definitely sticks to HTC's design language and has a glossy mirror finished body. HTC calls it liquid surface and it's made out of glass. This helps it stand out from every other flagship in the market. While it is stunning to look at, this phone is quite slippery and picks up fingerprints easily. So you will need to wipe it quite often to retain the shine. HTC also provides a transparent case in the box, which you can pop on the phone to keep it safe. The front is pretty much dominated by the big 6-inch display with thin borders on the sides and slightly bigger ones at the top and the bottom. This makes the phone narrow and tall, making it harder to reach the corners of the display. HTC had to move the fingerprint scanner to the back just below the camera module. The placement is convenient and it is quick to unlock the phone from. The phone has a metal band around it which houses the power and the volume buttons on the right, while the left is completely blank. The SIM tray slot is positioned on the top alongside one of the four microphones that the device has all around the body. At the bottom, there's a downward firing speaker alongside a USB Type-C port and the primary microphone. Sadly, the U11 misses out on a 3.5mm headphone jack, but HTC offers its HTC USonic Active Noise Cancellation headphones in the box. These headphones have a Type-C connector which can be plugged into the phone directly. There's a USB Type-C to 3.5mm dongle in the box which will be required if you wish to use regular headphones. You also get a Quick Charge 3.0 charger in the box. With the increase in size, HTC has packed in a larger battery, bumping the total capacity up to 3930 mAh, resulting in it weighing 188 grams. However, it does not feel bulky. Its premium glass back coupled with the weight gives an impression that it is solidly built. Internationally, the phone is available in 3 colors, but in India, HTC has launched only the amazing silver color, which looks more blue than silver. The HTC U11 Plus sports a 6-inch display with Quad HD Plus resolution, putting out close to 537 pixels per inch. HTC calls it Super LCD 6, and the panel supports the DCI P3 wide color gamut. You can also switch to sRGB output and tweak the color temperature to suit individual preferences. There's a layer of Corning Gorilla Glass 5 for protection. Powering the phone is the Snapdragon A35 SoC, an octa-core processor clocked at 2.45 GHz. There are two variants of the U11 Plus, one with 4GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage, while the other has 6GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. At this point, HTC only has the higher end variant on sale in India and it's priced at 56,990 rupees. It has also upgraded the IP rating from IP67 on the U11 to IP68 on the U11 Plus. HTC is known for its Sense UI skin and the U11 Plus runs it on top of Android Oreo. Features like notification dots and notification channels have been integrated into HTC's custom UI, but there are very few other visual changes in it compared to previous versions. Swipe right from the home screen and you are greeted by Blink Feed, which replaces Google Now. Sense UI also supports themes to customize the look of your smartphone. The U11 Plus gets HTC's Sense Companion AI assistant, which wasn't really helpful. HTC's EdgeSense technology uses sensors mounted on the side of the phone to detect squeezes. You can squeeze the phone to launch an app or summon the assistant. In fact, you can go a step further and set two different actions for a short squeeze and a long squeeze. There is no doubt that the HTC U11 Plus is a powerful smartphone. Its Snapdragon A35 processor coupled with 6GB of RAM is capable of bulldozing through anything you ask it to perform. The UI is smooth and it did not face any lags during our time with it. App load times are kept low and the phone can multitask easily. Benchmarks also reveal that it is a powerhouse. The display is vivid and has good viewing angles. It also has good brightness, but the screen is a little reflective when outdoors. apart from DCI P3 and sRGB display modes, the U11 Plus has HDR10 support. The earpiece doubles as a loudspeaker, while the one on the bottom acts as a subwoofer for a fuller sound. HTC's Boom Sound software also gives you music and theater modes to choose from. HTC managed to impress us with the camera on the U11, and the U11 Plus is no different. Apart from photo and video, you can choose panorama, hyperlapse, slow motion, or the pro mode. Once in pro mode, the camera gives you complete control over white balance, exposure, ISO, shutter speed, and focus. In this mode, you also get the option to save photos in RAW format. Photos taken with the HTC U11 Plus were impressive, and it is safe to say that it is one of the best smartphone cameras out there at the moment. The phone is quick to focus and the samples were crisp with good amount of details. We never had to adjust exposure when shooting in daylight, as the phone got it right every single time. Macros turned out even better, as the phone managed to capture fine details very well. Low light shots were bright, and the phone managed to capture details and colors accurately while keeping noise under control. The 8-megapixel front camera took good selfies as well and did not require any adjustments. The U11 Plus handles video recording brilliantly and is capable of recording up to 4K resolution videos. It has optical image stabilization, which greatly reduces shakes for stable footage. We found that it worked at 1080p but not at 4K. You can also record video with 3D audio, which utilizes the 4 microphones on the phone, or high-res audio at all resolutions. The 4K video is limited to 6 minutes and the phone gets warm to the touch. Just like the U11, this smartphone also gets acoustic focus, which uses the microphones to focus on a subject's voice over the background. The selfie camera tops out at 1080p and also gets the option to record 3D audio. It does not have optical image stabilization, so you will need a steady hand while recording. Battery life on the U11 Plus is good, and we managed to go through an entire day without needing to plug the phone into our charger. In our HD video loop test, it managed to go on for 13 hours and 4 minutes. When the battery finally runs out, you can plug it to the Quick Charge 3 adapter, which takes it to 60% in 50 minutes, but takes a little over 2 hours to charge it completely. If you are looking for a flagship smartphone, you now have one more option to choose from. The HTC U11 Plus has a big 18:9 display, powerful HTC Boom Sound speakers, and impressive cameras. HTC's Edge Sense isn't gimmicky, and the Snapdragon 835 SoC, coupled with 6GB of RAM, can run pretty much everything out there. The company also throws in its USonic Active Noise Cancellation headphones in the box. If you don't want the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus and were staying away from the Pixel 2 XL because of its display troubles, the HTC U11 Plus looks like the perfect alternative. HTC has also managed to price it aggressively at 56,990 rupees, making it great value for money. However, 2018 flagships with new hardware are just around the corner. Thanks for watching. For more tech news, reviews, and features, head straight to gadgets360.com.